All week long, we've been helping to kick off your holiday season with Christmas at the Mansions. The city was named by Travel and Leisure magazine as one of the best towns for the holidays, and we couldn't agree more. Michaela, how are you? You are live from the Breakers. How is it over there?
Yeah, that's right. It is fantastic. I'm kind of sad that it's our last day here, but we've got plenty to look forward to through. We've brought back Trudy Cox. She's the CEO of Preservation Society of Newport County. And thank you for, you know, kind of welcoming us into the Mansions for this entire week. It's been a lot of fun.
Thank you, Michaela. And the Rhode Show and Channel 12, we've had a ball having you here. I wish we could stay. You could stay for another week. Why not?
Yeah, why not is right. You actually have some things on the table here that we'd like to mention.
We do. This is a special present for you from the Preservation Society of Newport County. And there is a present for the great cameraman, Adam, and included in the packet is a scarf from one of our stores, there is a mug, there's some fudge, there's some great soap, there are stocking stuffers, there is a tie for Adam. We know that Adam loves ties.
There you go. Here you go, Adam. That's just for you. Awesome. And all of these things, too, they're great stocking stuffers. They're little items, too, that you can pick up right here.
Right here at the Newport Mansion stores, and we have packets for everybody back at the office, too. So thank you to Channel 12, and we really appreciate your support.
Well, it's been an exciting week for us here, but it's also been an exciting year for the Preservation Society as a whole, because this marks a particular halfway point. Tell us more.
Well, this is our 70th anniversary, and several years ago, we set out to achieve a 30-year goal, and it required the spending of $100 million. In the last 15 years, we've spent almost $50 million preserving and protecting the houses of the Preservation Society, which is an extraordinary job. The Breakers alone, we invest more than $1 million a year in taking care of this house. So this is an important tourist attraction for the state of Rhode Island. Mm-hmm. We employ 400 people. We generate $109 million for the economy of Newport. And we are preserving some of the most extraordinary houses in America. This is Europe in Newport, Europe in Rhode Island, Europe in the United States, and we love having people visit us.
Yeah, and you have so many people visiting, too, and I think that's where the employees come into play. You talk about 400 employees currently, but when the families were actually here living in the homes, it had much less.
Oh, yeah, less than 100. We are so understaffed compared to what the Vanderbilt family would have had, not only in the house but outside. And when you think about it, 400,000 people walked through the doors of the Breakers last year. So you have to have a lot of people paying attention and providing the kind of education that we want to provide to our visitors so that they learn about American history.
It takes a special group like the Preservation Society to put it all together. We're actually going to tell you a bit about how the Preservation Society got started when we come back.
The mansions in Newport have been painstakingly preserved for the public to enjoy, but have you ever wondered how they went from home to museum? Well, Michaela joins us from the Breakers with more right now. Hi, Michaela.
Hi, once again, there's plenty to see if you've ever been on a tour of the mansions or even a field trip. You learn a lot while you're here, but you're kind of left wanting to know more. Well, a new program allows students to do just that. So take a look at this.
Live in Newport at one of our properties and research a topic related to our mansions or Newport's history.
Many scholars have done just that.
I had gone to Salva here in Newport, so I knew about the Preservation Society. I heard about their fellows program, and it sounded like a great way to kick off my career.
Topics have ranged from pirates to pewter, archaeology to famous faces.
Alyssa is one of our star students, and she worked on the biography of our founder, Catherine Warren.
It was going to be just a 45-minute public presentation, and we found out that her story was so incredible that we wanted to write a book about it.
She had plenty to put in writing.
So she was one of the founding members of the Preservation Society and the first longtime president. She was president from 46 to 75. Most people associate the Preservation Society with the mansions and the Gilded Age, but it was really also very involved in preserving colonial architecture at the beginning, very beginnings in the 40s, 50s, and 60s. And we are so very proud of the Newport mansions, but we're also really proud of that early history and how we helped shape Newport.
So you talk about new and exciting things that the students discover. You're trying to match that excitement by giving them a place to reside.
We are, and right now we're in the process of rehabilitating imitating the carriage house at the Elms Estate that was built in the early 20th century.
It's pretty amazing that you were supposed to do a 45-minute presentation, right?
Yeah.
And now you have this physical book.
Yeah.
How cool is that?
It's incredible. I never thought, I don't think anybody thought when we started that that would happen. I never thought leaving grad school that I would write a book in 2 years. It's really been a great opportunity.
An experience she wouldn't have had without the Preservation Society.
The idea is that this experience is not only about the research and going to the libraries, but really about sharing ideas.
It's a really great opportunity to delve into a topic that you're really passionate about. You get to meet all sorts of people who will help you grow professionally.
So come on out to the Mansions and enjoy them this time of year. They are decorated for Christmas, and when we come back, we're going to have a little Christmas music to listen to as well.
Michaela, who is in Newport. Take it away, Michaela.
Yeah, you're right. One last time here at the Breakers. It's been a great week and a great day, so we figure why not cap it off with some Christmas music. John Black joins us once again. He's the director of music and choir. He's also the organist over at Greenwood Community Church. You've been doing this for 6 years, like you told us yesterday. What are those holiday events like for you? It must be such a fun atmosphere.
You know, the holiday evenings at the Mansions are a really special, very unique experience. We don't have people on rigid tours following a specific pattern. People are free to roam around, listen to the music, and I really get to interact with them. It's such a wonderful experience. But I have to tell you, one of the most fantastic things for me as a choral director is bringing a choir here for the first time to sing. The excitement they have ahead of time, and then when they finally sing in the space, hearing their voices here, it's just really special. So we're looking forward to doing that with the Greenwood Concert Choir in a few weeks.
And we're looking forward to hearing you play once again. What are you going to play for us today?
A rousing rendition of Joy to the World.
A rousing rendition. All right, John, take it away. More impressive, your playing or the fact that you can keep playing and turn the pages at the same time? How much practice did that take to actually turn the music while you're playing it?
Well, a couple of weeks and some engineering time to figure that out.
Can you teach me a quick little jingle here?
Okay, should we try Heart and Soul again?
Oh, we can do Heart and Soul. We've been working on this for a while. Okay. What part will I, oh, should I play?
Okay. Do you want to try the top?
Okay.
Ready?
Confused there, but hey, we're trying, and if you call out sick one of the holiday evenings, I can always fill in for you.
Thank you. Let me take you up on that.
Yeah, well, I don't know if you should take me up on that. All right, we've had a blast here at the Mansions. Play us out, John. Play whatever you want. This is the end of our time at the mansion, so come on out, enjoy the holidays here. Again, the Elms, the Breakers, and Marble House are all decorated through January 3rd.